what I did, can I kick it? Hold on, yeah, I got some rings and a range, can I kick it? Yeah, don't ask me a thing, how I got her, how I did it? Yeah, spend the whole half, had a blast, can I kick it? Yeah, even with a sprain, pain, can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain, can I kick it? Things ain't been the same, things have changed, can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
Hey, could count on my power and look at my dog, some. Way back then, you claim what you saw, but you weren't with us. The higher the climb, the harder the fall, but how
play action. Now Jackson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but
quarterback's got to get rid of it. They don't have the Tucker rule that they can fall back on anymore.
Second and 10. Here's Jackson again. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former USC man, Taylor Mays. And he will take this one home. They'll run for the first time with Raheem Mostert. And he's upended after a gain of four up to the 20.
Watch the curl. It's got Mike 50.
In your face.
They run out of the shotgun with Mostert. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs. Here's a first down throw that's complete, and he slips up past the 45 before being safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
And McCaffrey following the penalty, and he will be brought down at about the 43.
Directly that they would move the ball on the ground. Honed in on it and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Brings up third and six.
Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he'll get this into enemy territory.
At all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped him for almost no.
From the gun, Jackson. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. This is caught. Play fake. Here's Marino. And this is going to be in.
My 50. He can't hang. He's not going to get 19.
On second down, McCaffrey. And he's going to get this one down. Marino sets up. And they'll get this on the screen to most.
Wanted to. They force the third down. Blanketed the field with coverage. Nowhere to go with the football. Forced a dump off to the back. And even
pretty simple, one play drive, long pass, that maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive's exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. And lucky to go hide, and he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. After the interception, here's Marino. And he's taken down, but not before.
Red blitz got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit.
Another run, this time McCaffrey. And that'll get him halfway.
Cut back, it just never materialized.
They'll run with Mostert. And across the chalk, into the way. Taken in at the three. And he'll be brought to DK Metcalf. An 80-yard touchdown. And his guys have taken the lead. And the 49er hands team does its job. They'll try and throw forward. Marino looking for Thielen, but it's
showtime
intercepted.
Today, baby.
Picked off by Antonio Cromartie. And nothing but daylight ahead.
How you like me now?
And he will take this one home. It's a touch. Kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time. See if the... And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by 21 all the score as the kick's away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
It's worth noting when you talk about Jackson's running ability, the Baltimore wide receivers had just over 1,400 receiving yards combined last year. And Charles, that was the fewest yards by a wide receiver group in the NFL since 2011.
And partner, I expect that number to go up this year. Last season, Lamar Jackson got very comfortable with his tight end group. In fact, he had one tight end and went to the Pro Bowl. But I think now, because of his ability to run the ball, it'll bring defenders closer to the line of scrimmage, and you'll see more big plays from the wide receivers downfield.
Second and two.
Now facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. They go play action now. Jackson. Oh, and for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. Picked off for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. This will be fielded inside the five. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. And through the interception, we'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming.
They go play action with Jackson. Flushed out right. He'll try and run it. And he's able to take it across.